With me this morning from Tlou Energy, I'm joined by Tony Gilby. Tony, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. Great to be here.
And good to see you, Tony. You've had a half-yearly update out fairly recently. So how are the wells performing?
Thank you, Andrew. And indeed, we have just put out a half-yearly update. And there was a fair bit of information in that update in relation to the key risks that we have for the company going forward. In relation to the wells, one of the key risks for our success, of course, is that the wells produce not only gas, but abundant gas. As you'll recall, we have two lateral production pods, Lesedi 3 and 4, and they've been on production now for some time, pumping water and producing gas. The water information and the pressure information, particularly with Lesedi 4, but also for 3, but particularly with 4, are producing clear trends now. The wells in particular since earlier this year have started to be more consistent in their gas flows, and the trend lines with the produced water, barrels a day, with the pressure as determined in each of the lateral wells and the vertical well on each pod are all showing consistent trends. Now, the produced water with each pod is gradually reducing, but reducing at quite a slow rate. It's a fair question others have put to me at various times. Can we pump that water quicker? And the answer is a no, because it's just the way the wells are set up. We're being able to manage that water with our current pump setup. We can only pump at a certain rate. So the issue is actually the amount of water flowing into the lateral well bores coming to the vertical. So we're well and truly on top of the flow rate. We can only draw down at a certain a rate of barrels per day, but the amount of water coming into the laterals, until we get that down to as close to zero as possible, the wells won't be at their peak performance as far as the gas flow. So the objective is to continue to draw that water in from a long way away from the laterals, and as that water drops, the pressure regime will change and will allow the gas, the coal closer to the wellbore and further away from the wellbore to become more gas saturated and deliver that gas to the vertical. That is the time-consuming process, Andrew, and you can imagine that these production pods are in a region of our area and a part of the geological basin that has never had any dewatering before in the Lower Murupuli coal seam. So we're the first ones to do it. We're trying to pull quite a lot of water out of the coal seam in a brand new area. So unfortunately, it's taking time, but we see no real negative as far as the big picture is concerned, just that it's taking time. The final point on the well performance is with the constant water flow coming in, it means that the permeability, in other words, the interconnectivity of the little holes and fractures within the coal, the permeability is clearly quite good. And usually what happens with a good permeability ultimately results in a good gas flow. So again, Andrew, everything looks good except the amount of time it's taken to pull those larger volumes of water out of the coal.
Where are we at as far as project financing?
Going forward, we clearly need project finance to connect the Lesedi project to the grid, approximately 100 kilometres away at the township of Saroe into the Saroe substation. Now, we're really well advanced in our project finance discussions, particularly within the Botswana market. And we've been talking with a BDC for some time, Botswana Development Corp, and we feel we're close to coming to an agreement there. But until it's done, it's not done, of course, Andrew, and there's obviously fine-tuning by both parties to get an acceptable arrangement for both parties. The good news is if we can come to an arrangement with BDC, they are effectively an arm of the government, the Sovereign Wealth Fund, for want of a better term, And we know that with a successful financing arrangement with BDC, it will lead to expansion capital as well, and it minimises the potential need in the future to go back to the broader market. Now, obviously, raising project finance within the Botswana market is much more beneficial to the shareholders compared to raising project finance from elsewhere. We will go elsewhere if we need to, of course, but the more Botswana buy-in we can to the project and the project's future, the better it is ultimately for Tlou Energy and our shareholders. We're convinced of that, and we're getting good feedback from the Botswana market as well. Now, we do have backups to BDC. We're talking to the broader Botswana market as well, the so-called asset managers, and getting very good feedback there. As always, in a project finance and examples such as ours and project ours, the key is, of course, to get them over the line at a reasonable deal for the company. So that's what we're working on now, Andrew.
When you say expansion capital, are you referring to extra development wells?
Well, ideally, the project finance package would include a funding for extra development wells. The primary objective, however, is to connect the project to the grid so that we can produce electricity from the gas we're flowing now. And by the time we're connected to the grid, ideally, and if we remain on target, our objective is to connect to the grid later this year, we can convert what gas we currently have, what future gas we'll be producing between now and then, to the grid and become a revenue producer for the shareholders. So ideally, as I said, that package would include additional funding for additional wells, because quite simply, from what we've seen, our knowledge, our experience gained in drilling wells in this part of Botswana, the more wells we drill, all else being equal, the more gas will flow. And indeed, additional wells can assist with the dewatering. So we're still confident, until proven otherwise, that these pods will produce enough for our initial electricity generation project. But more wells, the merrier, effectively, Andrew.
And just on the dewatering, is that slowing down these financing discussions at all?
Not particularly. We haven't really had any pushback on that. We've taken a lot of the local asset managers out to the field. We've showed them the gas flowing. It's even more consistent now than when we have done that, when we've taken them out to show them the wells. So we haven't really had any negativity on the length of time it's taking for dewatering. I'm in Botswana at the moment, and the local asset managers understand that the wells need to be dewatered. They understand the process now. They've seen the gas flowing. Clearly, though, if the wells are kicked in with a higher rate sooner, it facilitates effectively closing project finance at a more advantageous rate for the company. But we're dealing with what we've got. We've got gas flows. They should build as more water comes out, and we'll be looking at closing the project finance irrespective of the the state of dewatering.
And just to re-emphasise, you do have a number of other alternatives lined up should these current financing discussions not lead anywhere.
Correct. And I mentioned, of course, other asset managers in Botswana, not only BDC. So we've taken the project finance proposals to all the asset managers within Botswana, and we've narrowed down that list to a series of parties who are still interested in hopefully bringing those discussions to fruition as an alternative or a backup or even a supplementary project finance package with a BDC. And we've also have parties external from Botswana which aren't quite as desirable for the company as getting more Botswana ownership. You'll recall that our largest shareholder is the Botswanan Public Officers Pension Fund. So that's already a very good endorsement of what we're doing within Botswana. Energy is required by the the country. They're currently importing over 500 megawatts a day from the data I've seen. So there is a real need for energy in Botswana. The big picture is most certainly intact for bringing up a new project such as ours, electricity into the grid, Andrew. So there is a lot of interest, not only in Botswana, but external. But as a plan B, if you will, there are external parties who have are looking at either a similar project finance package to what we've presented here, or indeed some equity.
Mm. And you're now discussing a potential temporary PPA. Can you tell me a bit more about this?
Yes, Andrew. And it's something that's come about because clearly the full PPA, if you will, has taken quite an amount of time so far. And we've pointed out to the authorities here who are working on the full PPA that investment capital, particularly foreign investment capital, is fluid. And the longer it takes, the more challenging it is for us. So we propose, and they have acknowledge the concept of a temporary PPA or something that will tide us over, if you will, between where we are now and where we are, and until we hopefully get a full PPA. Now, with the government has asked us to keep a broad PPA negotiation discussions confidential, which we'll of course honour, but also the government's allowed us to make some comments on the bigger picture, including the fact that they're looking at that temporary PPA. And we see it as an ideal interim solution that satisfies their needs to go through the processes with the full permanent PPA in great detail and allows us to get on with the project, facilitate our project finance, and then connect to the grid and get moving and produce electricity, Andrew, because it's one thing everyone recognises here, and we recognise as a company, that the need for the product is as strong as ever, and the sooner we get into the grid, the better for both the country and the shareholders.
And you're looking to add a bit of solar energy into the mix too. How's this come about?
Yes, indeed, Andrew. We updated the market with our current vision of a cleaner energy future, if you will, in relation to incorporating solar into our mix. Now, we've been thinking about solar for some time. We've mentioned it in our public releases in the background for some time, but that's really come to the fore of late based on world events, a world yearning for a cleaner energy. Gas, as you know, produces approximately a third of the carbon dioxide emissions as coal. So gas is a long way advanced in terms of a cleaner energy future. But when you combine it with solar, we get a really quite a powerful cleaner energy product for the market that not only appeals to a lot of our investors now, a lot of the investors in Botswana, but also works ideally with gas. Solar works ideally with gas. You can imagine the long sunny days in Botswana whereby solar can be produced, married with gas that will fill in the shoulders at dawn and dusk, and indeed keep producing electricity during the evening. So it's a very powerful combination. It's one that we'd dearly like to aim towards doing. And of course, as always, there'll be regulatory requirements, but all else being equal, we feel it's a very compelling case, and our investors appear to be well and truly supportive of that.
Just a final thought then, Tony, how are your confidence levels in the project at the moment?
The confidence levels remain very high, Andrew. Now, the headwinds of the broader market and the fact that things have taken a long time, I really do. It pains us as directors, as leaders of the company and as shareholders that things are taking so long, because the market is seeking results, and it does punish any company that takes longer than otherwise would be desirable. So our confidence remains supreme on the broader thematic of cleaner energy into the Botswana market and the broader Southern African power pool once we're connected to that grid. The upside is still there. We see a massive potential still in our gas property. Not only do we have the lower Murupuli coal that we're targeting now, but we have a shallower coal call this Rowie coal. We have a deeper coal as well. So there is a lot of gas-saturated coals that can deliver gas into our development once we get it up and running. And then combined with solar, we're very confident we're on the right track, Andrew.
Good to see you, Tony. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Andrew.